We have been looking for many years for a Sunday law to be enacted in our land. And now that the movement is right upon us, we ask, will our people do their duty in the matter? Can we not assist in lifting the standard and in calling to the front those who have a regard for their religious rights and privileges?
Greetings and welcome to another last day events as they are being fulfilled very, very rapidly. The mark of the beast crisis is indeed upon us. A careful study of Revelation chapter 13, specifically dealing with verses 15, 16, and 17, will show that the mark of the beast crisis brings also with it a food crisis. The mark of the beast crisis brings poverty. The mark of the beast crisis brings a system that we have been witnessing for the past 2.5 years. And that is totalitarianism, communism. We are seeing those things taking place today. We are being forced to live our lives according to a thus saith the government, or a thus saith the papacy. This is the time when God's people, as the disciples said in Acts 4 and Acts 5, we ought to obey God rather than men. With that in mind, let's have a word of prayer. Loving Father God, which art in heaven, we want to thank you again for opening our eyes to the signs of the times so that we will be without excuse. Lord, help us to take heed as you have revealed these things unto us. Now help us to put our faith into action so that we may be strengthened, encouraged, and grow in grace. We pray for your blessing upon us now. In Jesus' name, amen. Indeed, brothers and sisters, as the Bible says in Romans chapter 12, the Apostle Paul says, he commanded us to present our bodies as living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is our reasonable service. And this test to present our bodies as living sacrifice is upon us. The food crisis, as I stated, Revelation chapter 13, the mark of the beast crisis, brings to view a food crisis, a time of trouble like there never was. Let's begin here from Ezekiel chapter 7, verses 5 through 7. Thus saith the Lord God, an evil and only evil, behold, is come. An end is come. The end is come. It watcheth for thee. Behold, it is come. The morning is come unto thee, O thou that dwellest in the land. The time is come. The day of trouble is near, and not the sounding again of the mountains. The days of trouble indeed have come. Those days are upon us. The food crisis, the mark of the beast crisis are here. And this is, one more time, an indication telling us, as Jesus says in Matthew chapter 24, look at the fig tree. When its branch is yet tender, ye know that summer is nigh. In other words, as he also says, this generation shall not pass away until all these things be fulfilled. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass away. In other words, Jesus is saying those signs of the times are pointing toward the return of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Food crisis, to lead the people to beg for food and to accept whatever the government tells them to do, and eventually to receive the mark of the beast and to worship the beast. Notice what we read here. German food banks suffer as former donors forced to become recipients. With a big family to feed, no income, and rising prices, the 36-year-old had nowhere else to turn. In today's times, there is no money, but everything is very expensive, she says, especially when there is a big family, it is very difficult. One more time, Revelation 13, verses 16 and 17. You have to bring a condition of things to eliminate the middle class. You have to bring a condition of things whereas there will be a scarcity of food, lack of employment, so that the people could depend on the system, and they will do, since this has to do with their basic necessities, they will do whatever the government proposes. And the government will even force them to demand for what the government is already brainwashed them with, and that is the legislative, the enactment of the Sunday law, which is the solution to all of those problems that we see taking place in our world. Now, they brought about this food crisis, it's not only because they want to condition people, but also to change our diet, to change the way we eat, to change our behavior. Let's continue. Notice this next one here. Proposal to pay farmers 5,000 euros to cull cows, or that would be pound rather, to do what? Then it says the Department of Agriculture estimates the move would take 45,000 tons of carbon dioxide equivalent out of the atmosphere for every 10,000 cows culled. That would do what? It would, as they said, bring down carbon dioxide. Now keep in mind, they want to get rid of thousands and millions of cattle, because they say those cattle are endangering the planet. They are causing global warming because they are exhaling carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. Well, we do that too as human beings. We do exhale carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. So then, soon and very soon, they're going to tell you clearly, as they've been saying, but sometimes not so directly, that too many people, we have to get rid of some of them. But the question I would like to ask, since they are getting rid of the cattle, what do they want us to eat? Now remember, the Bible describes in Revelation chapter 13, this first beast, verses 1 through 10, that receive a deadly wound, and that first beast is the papacy, it's the Roman Catholic Church, it's the harlot woman of Revelation chapter 17. The latter part of verse 3 of chapter 13 says, and its deadly wound was healed, and all the world wonder after the beast. It is that same power that persecuted God's people during the Dark Ages. It is that same power that brought about a system that we have now today, whereas you have the peasants and the rich, and you have to be super rich as well. The peasants and the rich, that way you can control the minds of men. If you get rid of the middle class, which is as well Protestantism, if you get rid of them, then it's easier to enforce the mark of the beast upon many. But my Bible tells me that this light of truth about the Sabbath, which the Bible again says to remember the Sabbath day because the Lord Jehovah created us. The Lord Jehovah redeemed us. The Lord Jehovah is coming again, and when he comes, the saints of God will spend 1,000 years in heaven, 1,000 years Sabbath. This earth will experience. This is part of the bigger issue here, the great controversy, which authority, whose authority, which day we are going to observe, which seal are we going to receive? Will it be the seal of God or the mark of the beast? Well, let me go back. Who is behind this food crisis to change men's diet? Remember, if they are the ones feeding you, then they are the ones controlling you. If they are the ones telling you what you can and cannot eat, then they are in full control. The changing of the diet. Remember, the Bible warns us about what we put into the body. Leviticus, what is it, chapter 11, describe those clean and unclean food. The Bible tells us that there are things that we eat that will, like for example, alcohol, that would becloud the mind, that would cause us to not be able to discern spiritual things. And Babylon knows this. But here is another point. Both the Bible and spirit prophecy tell us that in these last days, God's people, according to Revelation chapter 14, verse 7, must go back to the Edenic diet. You see, God has a health message. Babylon, the Pope of Rome, the men of sin, also has a health message in these last days. He even calling for a vegetarian diet. Listen to this one here. Speaking of Babylon calling for a vegetarian diet, this is from Euronews Green. Pope Francis tells young people that eating meat is part of a, what are the words, self-destructive trend. In a letter to participants at the EU Youth Conference in Prague, the Pope urged that we break this self-destructive trend of consumerism and prioritize, quote-unquote, remember that word, sustainability. It is urgent to reduce consumption not only of fossil fuels, but also of many superfluous things. And also, it is convenient to consume less meat. This can also help, quote-unquote, save the environment. The question again, one more time. Since the Pope is advocating the eating of less meat, what kind of diet does he want us to have in these last days? Let's move on. This is from Vatican News. Pope urges inclusive and, again, there's the word, sustainable food systems. Okay, we're getting somewhere. He wants us to have to eat sustainable food to, quote-unquote, save the planet. A circular economy which guarantees resources for all. Notice it says a circular economy. Revelation chapter 13, verses 16 and 17 describe the so-called circular economy that the Pope is referring to. This is an economy that is controlled, that you do not have the freedom to choose even what you can and cannot eat, and what you can and cannot buy or sell. Everything must be monitored. Everything, it must be controlled under the umbrella to save the planet from climate change. And again, behind the climate change crisis is the mark of the beast crisis, which is Sunday law. Let's continue. It says again, a circular economy which guarantees resources for all, including future generations, and promotes the use of renewable energies. will help, notice the word creator, resilient, inclusive, and sustainable food systems that will provide healthy and affordable diets for everyone. So the Pope wants to be the one choosing the diet for you, your diet. He wants to be the one telling you what to eat. He's telling you what he believe and think is good for you, but you don't have a choice in the matter to say, no, I don't want that, because remember, this is the diet that we must have in order to save the planet from global warming. Let's move on. It goes on to say, an economy tailored to mankind. Notice the words again, one more time. An economy tailored to mankind. In other words, the diet that I'm choosing for mankind and the economy as well. Not subject only to profit, but anchored in the where? In the common good, friendly to ethics and respectful of the environment. So this economy, the diet that the Pope has chosen for us in these last days, not only will save the planet, but it is for the common good. And again, what is the common good? That is Sunday sacredness. Well, my Bible tells me, warns us, that we, again, Paul says in Romans chapter 12, I beseech you therefore, brethren, that ye present your body holy, as living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Whom are we going to serve? Whom are we going to allow to feed us in these last days? Are we going to complain like the children of Israel wanted the diet of Pharaoh, the diet of the Egyptians that was killing them, that was causing all kinds of diseases? Or are we going to accept this transition, however painful it might be, and choose the simple diet that God wants to give us in these last days, as he gave the children of Israel a simple diet? Let me read this for you here from the book of Revelation chapter 2 verse 20. Notwithstanding, I have a few things against thee, because thou sufferest that woman Jezebel. And that woman Jezebel in these last days represents the Roman Catholic Church, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed unto idols. The Pope wants us to eat the things that are unclean, the things that his gods, and even Satan his God, wants us to have in these last days. Now, mind you, brothers and sisters, this kind of diet that the Pope wants us to have, it's not to sustain us, as they use the word sustainability. It's not to sustain us, but it is to kill us, because that kind of diet will cause cancer. It has parasites in it. What kind of diet? The sustainability food that the Pope is talking about, that we must have in these last days in order to save the planet. There it is. This says, U.S. public broadcasting encourages people to eat what now? Tasty insects. For what reason? To help battle climate change. Last year, the World Economic Forum promoted the EU's new plan to use mealworms. What now? Mealworms in food, in their bid to reduce meat consumption. The globalists are pushing for the peasants to eat bugs, weeds, and synthetic meat. Synthetic meat. Because bugs consume fewer resources than traditional livestock. The European Union has ruled that the larval stage of the Tenebrio molitor beetle, the mealworm is quote-unquote safe for people to eat, and it will shortly be on the market as a novel food. Well, not shortly, it's already here. And they even have Hollywood, brothers and sisters, brainwashing their people, normalizing this Babylonian diet. Speaking of Hollywood, listen carefully here.
What is this? This looks like I could make cocoa with this. What is...
Right.
What is that?
Well, that's an insect-based premium protein. It's made from Molitor, which is mealworm larvae. The company is called Insect. This is in France. This is for fertilizer. Mm-hmm. And as you have there, this is a powder derived from the mealworm, and it's a insect protein just been approved by the EU for human consumption.
That was Robert Downey Jr., one of Hollywood's stars, who is also a gay LGBT individual. And he's promoting the eating of insects. And they talking about it as if it's normal. It's not a big deal. They are normalizing it. They are even in their shows, quote unquote, eating those things to brainwash the masses. Listen to the next clip.
It's just a protein supplement?
Exactly.
I can put this in a smoothie or something?
I'm telling you, yep, and they'll be making all kinds of stuff out of it. And by the way, it is the making of it is severely reducing the amount of emissions it takes. It is a innovation, Justin. We're doing something incorrectly. If we make this switch, it's a huge, huge intervention.
This is the mark of the beast diet. Oh, brothers and sisters. You see, the diet that you choose right now will also determine on which side of this great controversy you will find yourself in. If you choose the diet of the Lord, then you will be sealed. The diet of Babylon, then you will receive the mark of the beast. Because even way back in the garden, remember the seal of God, we find it at the heart of the Ten Commandments. That is the Sabbath. And in the garden, from the beginning, God had given men the diet, the plant-based diet, and rest, Sabbath. Now you have Hollywood one more time, that are out there from one show after another, and even in their movies, promoting the Babylonian diet. Let's continue. Notice from LifeSite, this says, snack food made with cricket protein, now being sold in Canadian supermarkets. The next time you bite into your cheese puffs, it might be best to read the ingredients label, as snacks made with cricket flour are now on sale at major Canadian grocery stores nationwide. The food brand called, that's the name of the food brand, Actually Foods, from Canadian base and Tomo Farms, says it is on a mission to renew Canadians' relationship with what they claim is quote-unquote healthy food. Actually Foods cheddar jalapeno puffs, which are mostly corn-based, lists as an ingredient organic cricket flour. Brothers and sisters, one more time, take your time, read the ingredients, read. Many of us don't do that. We treat our body, which is supposed to be the temple of the Holy Ghost, of the Holy Spirit, we treat it like it's nothing, like it's a garbage can, but we don't treat our vehicle that way. Read the ingredients of the things that you are buying, that you are going to consume. God will hold you accountable. I did not plan to make a video today, but as some of these articles were coming across my desk, I thought I better make a video about it, just in case some of you were heading to the grocery store, so you could stop yourself and read the ingredients, brothers and sisters. Because these things are now being put into your food, as you just heard from Robert Downey Jr. there. He said those things will be in everything. So you have to read carefully. And they are even putting them under the name organic. We have to be careful, because this body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. Satan wants to defile the body because he knows that if you put the wrong food into your system, spiritually, you will be dwarf. You will not be able to discern the counterfeit in these last days. And he knows that. And that's the reason why Daniel and his friends, one more time, they understood the spiritual battle. And that was one of the reasons why they purposed in their heart that they would not defile themselves with the king's meat. Listen now, same article. It goes on to say, both crickets and mealworms in recent months have been promoted by global elites as a source of protein that they say could replace beef or pork, and which can also use a variety of foods. Indeed, the Great Reset of Klaus Schwab and his World Economic Forum has as part of its agenda the promotion of eating bugs to replace beef, pork. We should not be eating meat anyway, and other meals that they say have high carbon footprints. Photos of the cricket-laced cheddar jalapeno puffs show it to look like, listen carefully, any other cheese puff, meaning some customers might be unaware they are eating bug flour. Oh, brothers and sisters, oh, read the ingredients. We have to be wise. Remember, Jesus says we have to be wise, discerning the times, because the days are evil. It is high time, the Apostle Paul says, to awake out of sleep. High time to awake out of sleep. As Revelation 12, verse 11 says, woe to the inhabitants of the earth, for the devil has come down upon you, because he knoweth that he has but a short time. They are doing everything they can from every direction, at every angle, to find a way to destroy us, either via pestilence, war, food crisis. Oh, brothers and sisters, listen now. This is the company by the name of Actually Foods that we were just talking about. You could see the link for the website or the website address there on the right side of your screen. It says here from their website, let's bring it back to real. It says, Actually Food is on a mission to renew Canadians' relationship with quote-unquote healthy food. We've ditched so-called natural ingredients that are actually not as clean as they claim. Instead, we're making something you can feel good about, using unexpected ingredients that, although surprising, actually boasts the health benefits you're looking for, like high protein, cricket powders, fava bean, and more. One more time, be wise in these last days. Understand that the enemy is out there to devour us, because the final act in the drama is upon us, and we need the spiritual stamina. We need to have clear minds in these last days. Listen, the website went on to say, we prioritize the quote-unquote planet just as much as we do our health. Our superfoods produce less emissions and waste than traditional health foods, so they're an easy choice for eco-friendly eaters, powered by sustainably farmed and then organic crickets. Our puffs are high in protein, rich in vitamins such as B12, and a natural source of prebiotics. They make it sound so good, so healthy for you. Again, as I mentioned, read, take your time and read the ingredients on those things, because sometimes it will be there, but in a way that you might just skip it, not realizing that it's there. For example, this is the ingredient there for the cheddar jalapeno puffs from the actual food company. It says puff, organic cornmeal flour, lentil flour, fava bean flour, rice flour, organic whatnot, cricket flour, and so on. Take your time once again. The way they put those things there, you might miss it. Oh, brothers and sisters, I beseech you therefore, as the Apostle Paul says, to present your body holy, as living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And again, the mark of the beast diet is upon us to make us drunk by the food, by the wine of Babylon. Listen to what Spirit of Prophecy says here. Volume 20, manuscript releases. We read in page 7, paragraph 2. Thou hast a few names, even in Sardis, which have not, notice the word, defile their garments. That is from Revelation chapter 3, verse 4. What does that mean? How are their garments defiled, is the question. The answer is, by eating of that which brings disease. And what else? Infirmity. Let me read that one more time. Thou hast a few names, even in Sardis, which have not defiled their garments. How are their garments defiled? By eating of that which brings disease and infirmity. So, those things, those Babylonian bugs, crickets, and all of those things will defile us. Satan does not want you to go to heaven, to be clothed with the righteousness of Jesus Christ. He wants you to defile this body. Let's move on. It says, and they shall walk with me in white, for they are worthy. He that overcometh, the same shall be clothed in white raiment, and I will not blot out his name out of the book of life, but I will confess his name before my Father and before his angels. Revelation chapter 3, verses 4 and 5. God wants us to overcome. We are living in this transition period. God also wants to transition us from this world into a world of love, peace, and joy, a perfect world. But it will not be easy. We have to overcome, and we can do it, as Revelation 12, verse 12, verse 10 says, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. Let's continue. Spirit of Prophecy says, volume 5, manuscript releases 225, paragraph 2. Eat simple, wholesome food, and eat it with thanksgiving. God will cooperate. I love that. God will cooperate with you in preserving your health if you eat with care, refusing to put unnecessary burdens on the stomach. God has graciously made the path of nature sure and safe, wide enough for all who will walk in it. He has given for our sustenance the wholesome and health-giving productions of the earth. So therefore, let us honor God, as Revelation 14:7 says, fear God and give him glory. Let us not, brothers and sisters, labor, as the Bible says, to put things in the body to satisfy the flesh. Remember, Jesus says again, as he was overcoming appetite, men shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. And as John 6:27 says, labor not, Jesus himself was speaking, labor not for the meat, that is food there, which perisheth, that's the physical food, but for that food which endureth unto everlasting life, that would be the word of God, which the Son of Man shall give unto you. For him hath God the Father, what's the word? Seal. So labor not for the physical food. Don't fall into the temptation. Don't be so quick to try to satisfy the flesh, the desire of the flesh, the hunger. Endure as faithful servant, endure till the end. And then God will seal you. Amen, brothers and sisters. The mark of the beast diet is upon us. But God has called us for such a time as this, to honor him, to give him glory, to overcome self, to overcome the flesh, to overcome sin, to overcome the devil. Let's have a word of prayer. Loving Father God, which art in heaven, time of trouble is upon us indeed. But you have given us the assurance that you will be with us. You have given us the assurance that you will not leave us nor forsake us. Lord, help us to accept the bitter cup, the cross. Help us to subdue this flesh and to surrender all to you. We pray that you would help us to endure till the end. In Jesus' precious name, amen.